Hello everyone, welcome to AeroHub and welcome to the series of lectures in airframe structures. In this lecture we will discuss about an important theory in aircraft structures, that is Breed-Bartow theory or Breed-Bartow formula, and also it is nothing but the relationship between shear flow and the torque. Okay, it is also known as the relationship between shear flow as well as torque. Relation between shear flow and torque. Now you can see in this section we have a circular thin wall section having a thickness of smaller than t, and the center is denoted as capital letter O, and I am applying a torque, a twisting moment of capital T for this section, and under the action of this twisting moment the shear stresses will be parallel to this section. Since the thickness is very small, the shear stress will be acting, let shear stress is tau, and the shear stress will be acting parallel to this boundary. Okay, and that is tau will be parallel to boundary. And you have to also understand that since the thickness is very small, the shear stress will be constant in thickness direction. Okay, so the shear stress will be constant in thickness direction. Now I will take a small element ds. This is element ds of the small element having a length of ds, and the thickness is ds, and you have to also understand there will be some amount of twisting moment acting on this element ds, that will be dt, and the shear stress acting on this element will be tau. Okay, you have to understand that there will be some amount of twisting moment will be acting on this element ds, and that twisting moment will be dt. Dt will be the twisting moment on element ds, and we have a force shear, we have a stress acting as tau, shear stress, and the total force acting, that is df, is the total force acting on this element. So df will be, we have an element of length ds and the thickness is t, therefore the area will be ds into t. This is the area of the element, and we have a shear stress acting, that is tau, and this will be the force acting on this element. Now to find out the twisting moment on this element, we will take moment about point O. Taking moment about O, this point, and let this distance be ON. Okay, and this will be the perpendicular distance, and this length will be the line of action. Okay, this will be the perpendicular distance ON. So dt will be equal to df into ON. Okay, now I can write dt is equal to tau into t into ds. This is the force, and I have a perpendicular distance ON. Okay, now I will multiply and divide by 2 on right hand side. So dt will be equal to 2 times tau into t into 1 by 2 ds into ON. Okay, listen, This is your triangle. This is O, this is N, and this length is DS. And half into DS into ON gives the triangle. That is the enclosed area of this triangle. So I can write half DS into ON as the area of this small triangle DA. Okay, so DT is equal to 2 times tau into T into DA. Okay, now to find out the twisting moment for the entire section, we will integrate the equation. I put this equation as 1. So this will be integral DT is equal to integral 2 times tau into T. These are constants. So 2 times tau into T integral over A DA. So finally, we will be getting T is equal to 2 tau T into A. Okay. Now, what is this tau into T? That is nothing but your shear flow. Okay. So T is equal to 2 times Q into area, or T is equal to the famous equation 2AQ, and this is called Breedbarth theory or Breedbarth formula, and this is the relationship between torque and the shear flow, applied torque and shear flow, where A is the enclosed area. That is the entire area inside this. This will be the area. Okay. So this equation we'll be using to find out the value of in the last lecture we discussed about shear of closed section beams, and we have QS is equal to QB plus QS naught, and we will be finding out the value of QS naught by taking the moment about a point for a section, and we'll be using the Breedbarth theory to find out the value of this QS naught. So this theory is used to find out the value of QS naught, which is nothing but the shear flow at the position of cut. Okay. So that's all about this lecture, and we'll be discussing numerical problem in the further lectures. Thank you so much. Please do share the channel and watch the videos. Thank you so much.